The shark remains in the bay. It already sounds scary enough. K'Juan Williams returning to the 49ers roster after getting a deal done. And according to multiple reports, you had a number of potential suitors as one of the top slot corners available. You had some visits with some teams, had some options to go closer to home, which is in Paterson, New Jersey, but ultimately deciding to return to the Bay Area. Why?
I mean, why wouldn't I? You know, I got all my guys I've been playing with. I play with, you know, Jaquaski, Jimmy's still here. E-Man just signed his deal. I'm excited for him. And just, you know, the whole group as a unit, you know, I feel like we can excel moving forward and, you know, take our defense to the next level.
So how was this free agency process for you? Were there specific boxes that needed to be checked in determining where to go? Was it just looking at the history of you and these guys on the field with you? How heavily were you involved? Just detail that process for us.
It's kind of stressful, but exciting at the same time. You know, I got a chance to see my options out there, and a lot of our guys on our team did a good job, you know, keeping in contact with me, making sure, you know, making sure I made a good decision. It was best for me, but they ultimately wanted me to come back here and be a part of the journey for this year. Yeah.
I actually wanted to know, how many texts or DMs would you say that you received from, maybe it's guys around the team, guys within this locker room, people lobbying for your talents? I'd assume it was a lot.
Yeah, it was a lot. You know, Juice was staying in contact. Kittle, Jimmy, Jason, all those guys were just always just wanting me to keep them posted on things and updating my how my offseason was going and how the visits and everything was going.
That's a lot of love. We even heard from your teammate Jaquaski Tard. He was one of them. He was talking to the media, and he said he's been trying to reach out to get you back, and there are a number of question marks in the assumption that this defense could have looked vastly different this year with the number of free agents there were. However, 49ers able to retain a number of you guys. For you, how important is that consistency on defense, especially in the secondary? You're playing with some of the same guys you've been playing with for a while, Jaquaski, E-Man, Jason Verrett, so on and so forth.
I mean, it's vital just having those guys with experience back there. You know, Jimmy played a lot of snaps in the league. He didn't play nickel. He didn't play the corner and safety. Verrett and took his game to a higher level this year, last year. And E-Man, he was part of our run in 2019, and he just consistently just been there for us and just answered every time we called on him. So just having a lot of guys, even the linebackers, you know, Fred, Dre, and everybody just being together, we just communicate. It should be smooth on the communication end, and it should be great for our defense.
I want to talk about you being that first outside free agent signing of John Lynch and Kyle Shanahan's era in 2017. They obviously think very highly of you, and we see it every time they speak of you. They have great things to say talking about the Shark, but how much did that relationship play a part in your decision to return?
It was everything. You know, those guys really looked out for me when I was coming back into the league in 2017, and they believed in me. You know, I mean, they signed me and they wanted me here. You know, I had other visits also, and they made sure I wanted to stay here in the Bay. Shout out to those guys. You know, they did a great job in terms of our relationship over these past few years, and I'm just happy to be here and continue with them.
You said the word relationship. So we talked about the guys on this defense. You brought up Fred Warner. You talked about Jimmy Ward, Jaquaski, E-Man. The list goes on and on. But looking at these guys and who you're familiar with, what are you guys capable of? What's your thoughts on this unit going into 2021?
I mean, there's no limit. You know, a lot of our guys can play at a high level, like across the board. We can all play at a high level. It's just up to us to bring it to the table and just like really, really put it on tape. At the end of the day, it's just up to us to take control of our defense and control what we can control and just be dominant as a unit.
There's no limit to what this unit can do, and they especially can do it because now the Shark is back in the Bay Area. K'Juan, glad to have you back, and can't wait to see more of you in 2021.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.